Well, one of the biggest casualties of the convoy of protesters through Canberra's streets has been a major fundraising event for Lifeline. Organisers were forced to call the annual book fair off, which was tipped to raise more than $1 million amid safety concerns. And Lifeline Canberra CEO CarrieLeeson joins us now. Carrie, can you tell us just what was going on that made you feel that it just wasn't safe to proceed with the event?
Look, unfortunately, the lead up to the book fair was unimpeded and uninterrupted, but with the 10 to 15,000 individuals that descended on Exhibition Park on the Friday night and early hours of Saturday morning, we saw a change in the environment, with obviously fences being removed and cut down, and the venue and the location that was allocated for the Lifeline Book Fair was then in line. And unfortunately, our members of the public and the community who'd had some unfortunate interactions with some of the protesters, a minority the day before, that all weighed on the decision to not have 20,000 people come in to support the Lifeline Canberra Book Fair whilst 20,000 were trying to get out to protest.
But Carrie, we know how important your work is, particularly through these difficult times. How much were you counting on this fundraising event?
We were very much counting on the book fair at Exhibition Park because we haven't been able to hold our book fair there for 2 years now. Exhibition Park has been a COVID testing centre for that period of time. So we've been able to hold a number of smaller fundraisers over the period in between lockdowns, but this was our great comeback and something the community were very much looking forward to, as well as our volunteers. And obviously it was going to raise much needed funds to be able to support the crisis support line for those millions of callers that do reach out for help throughout the year.
Carrie, it's really unfortunate that this has happened. Will you be able to raise the money through other events?
Yes, we will do our absolute best. We're still in the response stage and the wrap-up stage, and we're moving out of Exhibition Park as we speak. One thing that we didn't foresee happening when we made the decision early Saturday morning to cancel was that the community would very much make other plans and replace their book purchases with donations. So what we're seeing is an influx of generosity and kindness from so many thousands of Australians to support us and try and make up the shortfall.
Carrie, are you saying that you've got just as much in donations, but you also get to keep all the books? It sounds like a pretty good result.
It really does. Look, I'd be lying if I said our volunteers weren't devastated by what has occurred. But yes, some of them are very attached to their books and they make sure they go to good homes. So the fact that they've been able to hold on to them, pack them up and take them back to the warehouse, it's a small, small consolation.
Carrie, we love what Lifeline do on this show. We think it's a fantastic organisation. I understand that protesters have been a threat to the book fair this time, but there might be another threat looming. Have you heard about the Kindle?
Yes, I have. In fact, it was one of the things added to my list when I started in this role 7 years ago. We thought that the end of the book fair was nigh because of the Kindle. Fortunately, people love the feel and the smell of a book, and they love Lifeline even more. So any excuse to come down, a handful of books equals the cost of a life-changing call. So it's a win-win.
Carrie, it's such wonderful work that everyone at Lifeline does. Thanks so much for chatting with us.
Thanks for having us on.
And if you'd like to donate to Lifeline Canberra to help make up for the money they lost this weekend, or simply to just support their great work, just head to lifelinecanberra.org.au.